Hey, I'm ThinkerThunker. This is the Ranchita Woodape or Bigfoot photo. And for years now, I've been noticing where skeptics and popular opinion givers here on YouTube and blogs out there on the net have all sold themselves not only as Bigfoot experts, but as Photoshop and technical experts, declaring this photo and others like it as being Photoshopped hoaxes. So I'm going to put their expertise to test on this, and I'm going to show you a simple way that proves this was not Photoshopped. And to set the record straight, no, I am not a Bigfoot expert, but then nobody is. For lack of a better term, I'm more of a common sense expert and a video rehab expert and a photography expert who studied filmmaking and sound design and writing and on and on and on. And I'm also an expert with compositing and motion graphics and special effects software and 2D and 3D animation software. So I know what it takes to digitally fake photos and even video. I've also trained as an artist and painted portraits my entire life, or most of it. And I believe it's that artist eye, you know, that helps me spot these little details that for some reason go overlooked. But then my actual degree is in computer science. So logic and critical thinking play a huge part of what I do. That's what makes me ThinkerThunker. And that's what sets me apart from opinion givers who literally churn out hundreds and hundreds of videos a year. Because giving opinions like they do with zero proof backing their claims is easy to do. Anybody with a microphone and some editing software can do it. I've been ThinkerThunker for over 7 years now here on YouTube, and I've learned a few things and I've gotten better and faster at what I do, but I still have less than 80 videos to my credit because what I do takes time and energy, thought, and research. This simple little video on one photograph took me 2 weeks to put together. You know, I might joke around some here or there, but I take being ThinkerThunker very seriously. And it bothers me when I know good people are being sold something that isn't true. Let's check it out. I forgot to mention I know Photoshop pretty well too. And here we are in Photoshop with this this handsome rascal here who looks like he just got told he has jury duty over spring break. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to show you what it would take to Photoshop something. See all those hairs there? I would kind of have to keep going like this for hours and hours, selecting each hair, trying to separate him from all of that greenery back behind him. And it would take forever, and you're still not going to get it done. And I could say, okay, forget that. I'm going to go in and try to do this by selecting a color range. But even that is not going to do a perfect job. And the reason is, like this photograph here, this guy was out in a jungle. Well, jungles are generally full of greenery. And so sunlight comes down. It hits all that greenery. All of that light, all of that color bounces all around, refracts off of everything. And so forever, this jury guy here is going to have all of the colors that were around him and the color of the sky reflecting in his skin and fur. And it becomes kind of like his color DNA or the color DNA of this photograph, if that makes sense. Okay, so here I've dropped the jury duty guy and three other random gorillas all on top of the Ranchito photograph. Now, before showing you the real proof, I want to show you a huge problem with trying to Photoshop something. Okay, look at the woodape up here. Look at his eyes in heavy shadows. Look at his ears in heavy shadows. That would suggest that the sun was way back here on the other side of him. Well, look at the branches here. Exact same. The sun was back behind them. So if this was faked, I'll say somebody was brilliant and extremely lucky in that they found a gorilla who, that when its picture was taken, the sun was in the exact same position as the sun in this Ranchita photograph. And also look at the warmth on this tree here, and the warmth, it matches exactly on this gorilla. Those are at least signs to me that this was not Photoshopped. Look at these four down here. Were their faces filmed or photographed with heavy shadows over their face? No. So they wouldn't have worked for this photograph. Okay, so here is a simple test anybody can do. I'm going to just simply start bumping the saturation on this photoshopped image of five gorillas, and we're going to see their color DNAs for each photograph, see if they match or not. And you can already see some weird things are starting to happen. Look at these guys. They just went complete blue. Look at all of this. Look at this guy was kind of close to our wood ape, but still all of this blue in his face and our jury duty guy. And look at the tree color DNA and the wood ape and all these branches. Even at these extreme levels, they behave exactly the same. Whereas all these other four gorillas, their color DNA just blows out and goes a completely different direction. And even among the four down here on the bottom, their color DNA doesn't match each other. So it just proves that it is almost impossible to find two pictures where the color DNA matches even close. So now I'm going to drop in a fifth guy, and a prominent Bigfoot blog posted an article about a cryptozoologist who, when he found this photograph right here, and he saw the red in the hair here and the red in the wood ape, he said, that's it. Case closed. This was a hoax. If this guy can have red hair, that means this is a gorilla. And so, see, you don't have to think very deep to be a skeptic or an opinion giver. If something is even sort of close, good enough. That's good enough for those guys. Okay, so now let's put this big blog and their cryptozoologist to the test, the saturation test, and see if their game over ape is a perfect match. Now, I'm going to let you decide. Is the game over ape here on the right a perfect match to the Ranchita photograph? No, not even close in a billion years. I mean, the color DNA gave it away. So see, just the opinion that, this looks like that. Saying something looks like something is meaningless when a simple little test like this can prove it wrong. Okay, now we'll take this to extremes. Can the color DNA be edited? Look, I took the jury duty guy and I changed his colors and tones and all to more closely match the wood ape. Now watch. If I start pushing the saturation, look at that. So in a sense, I did change his color DNA, and it even got close to the Ranchita photograph up here. So yeah, color DNA can be changed, but there's another test that will still bust photoshopping. So look at this. Here the gang is. I've dropped a simple little artistic filter on them. And this filter's job is to find and accentuate edges. Well, the problem for anybody who's tried to Photoshop something, anytime you cut something out, you're going to have edges. And look, it found those edges and outlined them. Every one of these guys has an outline on it now, and that it doesn't match the Ranchita outline at all. So busted again. And if you tweak that some, it becomes even more apparent. Look at the game over ape now. Just two simple little tests blew that theory completely out of the water. So the next time you hear that it was Photoshopped excuse, now you know, it's 1,000 times harder than that person thought it was. And even if they were good at Photoshopping something in, now you know there are simple little tests that could bust them. And I would say there isn't a soul in the world, take the top Photoshop expert in the world, if they cut out something and drop it in masterfully into another photograph, simple little tests like we've done today can bust them. And that's just for single photographs. If we're talking about video, now it is a million times harder to drop something into a video and make it match not just one photograph. photograph, but 30 photographs per second. All but impossible for most. So, what is this guy up here? Because it wasn't photoshopped. Whatever it is, it was there that day. And we see a mountain back there. It looks like the mountain's there near Ranchita. So, what is it? Now, I'm going to do a second video that I go into. I've found some things about this guy that prove that it is not a gorilla. It looks more like a gorilla-human hybrid. And I'm also going to point out something really simple that proves this photograph did not come from some zoo. That video will be reserved for my new members here on YouTube. And of course, my patrons over at Patreon, those guys take care of me. So I'm going to start doing more and more videos just for them. So it's just $1 a month. Click the join button down below, sign up, be part of the tribe. All right, guys, that is all I've got. Thank you so much for watching. Your time to weigh in. Now you know for sure the difference between what I do and what other guys do. I don't tell you what to think. I don't just give you my opinion. I show you example after example. I do whatever I can so that you'll see what I'm talking about. All right. And just for fun, head out there, do some searches, and find the guys who said this was photoshopped beyond a shadow of a doubt. And now you'll know something those experts don't know. All right. Take care.